Hello, the topic of the video is intra-domain routing and inter-domain routing. The topics to be covered in this video are introduction of routing protocol, intra-domain routing, distance vector routing, link state routing, inter-domain routing and path vector routing. The first topic is introduction of routing protocol. A routing protocol specifies how routers communicate with each other. Routing algorithms determine the specific choice of the route. A routing protocol shares the information first among immediate neighbors and then throughout the network. The specific characteristics of routing protocols are A. The manner in which they avoid routing loops. B. The manner in which they select preferred routes. And C. Routing protocols use information about hop cost. Routing protocols are classified as intra-domain and inter-domain routing. Intra-domain routing is further classified as distance vector routing and link state routing, whereas inter-domain routing is classified as path vector routing. The first type of routing protocol is intra-domain routing. Intra-domain routing protocol is defined as the routing inside an autonomous system. Each autonomous system can choose one or more intra-domain routing protocols. Intra-domain routing is based on unreliable datagram delivery. The first type of intra-domain is distance vector, in which routing information protocol is used. Each neighbor exchanges information periodically to its neighbor in distance vector routing. Second type of inter-domain routing is link state, which uses open shortest path first protocol. In link state protocol, each network shares information periodically to other routers. This figure explains the distance vector protocol. When the routing table of a node changes, the node sends its table to its neighbor. A node updates its table with information received from its neighbor. In distance vector routing, the least cost route between any two nodes is the route with minimum distance. For example, the least cost to reach node E from node A is 6. The route passes through node C. Routing information protocol implements distance vector routing directly with following considerations. Autonomous system deals with routers and networks, and routers have routing tables. Destination in the routing table is a network, which means first column defines a network address. The metric used by routing information protocol is very simple. The metric in RIP is called as a hop count. The next node column defines the address of the router to which the packet is to send. This figure explains link state routing. Each node floods its local information to every other node in the network. Each node ends up knowing the entire network topology. In open shortest path first, all the routers in the domain come to a consistent view of topology. Router describes its local connectivity in a link state advertisement. Bulk of OSPF processing is due to LSA. OSPF processing impacts convergence. Areas to handle routing efficiently and in a timely manner, OSPF divides an autonomous system into areas. The second type of routing protocol is inter-domain routing. Inter-domain routing protocol is defined as the routing between autonomous system. Only one inter-domain routing protocol handles routing between autonomous system. In inter-domain routing, one node acts on behalf of the entire autonomous system. Inter-domain routing uses path vector protocol, in which border gateway protocol is used. This figure shows path vector routing. The principle of path vector routing is similar to that of distance vector routing. In path vector routing, we assume that there is one node in each autonomous system that acts on behalf of the entire autonomous system. Let us call it the speaker node. The speaker node in an autonomous system creates a routing table and advertises it to speaker node in neighboring autonomous system. Speaker nodes in each autonomous system can communicate with each other. In border gateway protocol, each domain is identified by a unique autonomous system number. BGP does not suffer from the count to infinity problems that affect distance vector routing protocols. BGP routers does not send the entire contents of its routing table to its neighbor regularly. A BGP session is established between two routers belonging to two different domains that are directly connected.